and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please call the roll.
DeYoung.
Here.
Greenerhorst.
Here.
Kim Stryland.
Here.
Peterson.
Here.
And Bachelman and Skibunner absent.
Very good, thank you. I would like to announce that there will be a policy and planning meeting following the regular council meeting to discuss a proposed development agreement with Lely North America. And I will make a note, we are going to change the order slightly. We will do that before the closed session. So that will be before item number four. We'll move on to the approval of the tentative agenda. Do I hear a motion for approval?
So moved.
Ben Stryland, support DeYoung. Any discussion? Seeing none, all in favor, please say yes. Opposed, no. Clerk call the roll.
Ben Stryland.
Yes.
DeYoung.
Yes.
Greenerhorst.
Yes.
Peterson.
Yes.
Motion carried. On to item number three, a certified list of police officer candidates. Mike, could you explain the list?
Yes, Mr. Mayor, I'd be happy to. I'd like to direct everyone's attention to the presentation on this item. You know, background on this on September 18th, the Civil Service Commission conducted oral interviews and also a comprehensive review of qualified candidates for the officer of police, position we currently have open. Now, as far as the candidates that passed the comprehensive exam and process with the Pella Police Department and were certified by the Civil Service Commission, they're listed up on the big board. And with this, Mr. Mayor, before council takes consideration this item, I'd like to turn the floor over to Chief Wilkinski to fill in the missing details that I fill in more background on the process for the city council.
Well, thank you, Mr. Murphy. Yes, we had, I believe it was a total of 49 candidates actually apply for the position, and we're experiencing the same thing other agencies in Iowa are, about a 50% show rate for the actual testing, and that's about what we had. It is rigorous testing, written examination, it's state required, physical fitness test required by the state, and then they sit through, at this stage, two interviews. One is a board interview with our staff, our lieutenants, and administrative services manager, and then an interview in front of the civil service board. And at the end of it all, this is what we felt comfortable with and the civil service board as well, as far as qualified candidates for this position.
Do I hear a motion for approval to accept this list of candidates?
So moved.
Support.
Peterson, support Greenerhorst. Any discussion? Seeing none, all in favor, please say yes. Opposed, no. Clerk call the roll.
Peterson?
Yes.
Greenerhorst?
Yes.
Ben Stryland?
Yes.
DeYoung?
Yes.
Motion carried. On to item number four, I would like to announce that there will be a closed session pursuant to Iowa Code Chapter 21.51J. To discuss the purchase or sale of particular real estate, only where the premature disclosure could be reasonably expected to increase the price the governmental body would have to pay for the property or reduce the price the governmental body would receive for that property. And again, we will do the policy and planning with the proposed development agreement with Lely North America before we go into closed session. So, now we'll move on to the public forum. If there's anyone in attendance that would like to discuss or comment on any agenda items, please step forward, speak into the microphone, give us your name and address, and keep it to 3 minutes, please. Seeing none, we will move on to the approval of the consent agenda. Do I hear a motion for approval?
So moved.
Support.
Greenerhorst, support Ben Stryland. Any discussion? Seeing none, all in favor, please say yes. Opposed, no. Clerk call the roll.
Greenerhorst?
Yes.
Ben Stryland?
Yes.
Peterson?
Yes.
DeYoung?
Yes.
Moving on to public hearings, item number D1, a public hearing on the proposed Lely Urban Renewal Plan. Mike, could you explain, please?
Yes, Mr. Mayor, and actually with this request, Mr. Mayor, we are requesting the council continue this public hearing until October 15th at 7 p.m. right here at the public safety complex. And the reason for this is we want to make sure that we have a work session on this item just to make sure we answer council's questions on this item. We've discussed it a number of months ago and we wanted to touch base on it. And two, we're still making minor adjustments to the map area for the urban renewal area. So once again, we're simply asking for a continuance on this item until October 15th. We'll consider if council approves a motion to do that at
All in favor, please say yes. Opposed, no. Clerk call the roll.
DeYoung.
Yes.
Dan Straylin.
Yes.
Peterson.
Yes.
Brandon Horst.
Yes.
Motion carried. On to item number two, a public hearing on the proposed development agreement with Lely North America. Mike, I assume it's in the same situation?
Absolutely, Mr. Mayor. And we'd like to point out that during policy and planning, that we will be having extensive discussion on the proposed development agreement. But with this, for purposes of the public hearing and in consideration, formal consideration of the development agreement, we're asking the council simply continue the public hearing until Tuesday, October 15th at 7 p.m.
Very good. Thank you, Mike. Do I hear a motion to continue the public hearing to October 15th, 2019 at 7?
So moved.
DeYoung. Support Peterson. Discussion? Seeing none, all in favor, please say yes. Opposed, no. Clerk call the roll.
DeYoung.
Yes.
Peterson.
Yes.
Brandon Horst.
Yes.
Dan Straylin.
Yes.
Motion carried. On to petitions and communications. Item 1A, a special event permit request for the holiday season in Pella. Mike, could you explain, please?
Yes, Mr. Mayor. This request that we're considering this evening comes to us from Ace Alliance, and as the mayor stated, holiday season 2019 in Pella. Now, as far as the kickoff of this, it will start on November 25th. Council approves this request tonight with the tree lighting ceremony, and we do have the request for the specific dates listed up here, and also the description of the activities that will occur on these dates as well. Corey, let's go ahead, please. Now, along with this, it is important to note that we do have a resolution, and the resolution is to close any parking spaces on Franklin Street in front of the information of the windmill as well, and that is to accommodate proposed carriage rides that will take place as part of the event. It is important to note, Mr. Mayor, that all city departments have reviewed this application. In addition, they have received a fee and insurance certificate, and we are recommending approval this evening.
Thank you, Mike. So it sounds like we are going to have holidays in the city of Pella. Do I hear a motion? Well, if we approve it, do I hear a motion for approval?
So moved.
Brandon Horst.
Support.
Support Ms. Dryland. Any discussion? Seeing none, all in favor, please say yes. Opposed, no. Clerk call the roll.
Brandon Horst.
Yes.
Dan Straylin.
Yes.
Peterson.
Yes.
DeYoung.
Yes.
Motion carried. On to 1B, resolution number 6020, titled resolution temporarily closing public ways or grounds in connection with a special event known as the holiday season in Pella. Mike, is there anything to add?
No, sir.
Do I hear a motion for approval?
Move to adopt.
Move to adopt by DeYoung.
Support.
Support Ben Stryland. Any discussion? Seeing none, all in favor, please say yes. Opposed, no. Clerk call the roll.
DeYoung.
Yes.
Dan Straylin.
Yes.
Peterson.
Yes.
Brandon Horst.
Yes.
Motion carried. The holidays are assured. Move on to number two, a new Class B wine permit for Casey's General Store, number 2598. Mike, could you explain, please?
Yes, Mr. Mayor, I'd be happy to. This request, as the mayor said, came from Casey's. It's actually for Casey's that's located at 414 South Park Street. And specifically, they have applied for a new Class B wine permit. Now, the Class B wine permit allows applicants to sell wine for off-premises consumption. Now, council will to approve this. New permit for the new wine permit would expire with the current Class E liquor license, which expires on June 7, 2020. It is important to note the application was completed upon line of escape, and we are recommending approval this evening, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you, Mike. Do I hear a motion for approval?
So moved.
Brandon Horst.
Support.
Support Peterson. Discussion? Seeing none, all in favor, please say yes. Opposed, no. Clerk, call the roll.
Brandon Horst.
Yes.
Peterson.
Yes.
DeYoung.
Yes.
Dan Straylin.
Yes.
On to resolutions. Item number one, resolution number 6021, entitled resolution certifying the population of recently annexed territory to the city of Pella. Mike, can you explain, please?
Yeah, Mr. Mayor, as it is this evening, this is the last step in our voluntary annexation in the Newland Drive area. It basically, when we look at this, the city soccer complex is over here, 218th Avenue is here. Everywhere that you see in purple was voluntary annexed. This is the last step in the process to complete the annexation. And simply what we have to do is certify the population for the annexed area, and it's a total of six individuals that live in this area. So with this, Mr. Mayor, approval of this resolution completes the voluntary annexation in the city of Pella, which is over 35 acres on a completely voluntary basis.
Good. Thank you, Mike. Do I hear a motion for approval?
So moved.
Dan Straylin. Support DeYoung. Discussion? Growing leaps and bounds. Six people. All right. So, Mike, I do want to ask, we will at some point need to recertify the wards to make sure that the population is balanced. And when does that occur?
That will be with the census.
That'll be with the census and down the road a little ways.
Yep.
All right. Very good.
Has that not been done since 2010?
Okay.
We got time to grow some more then, don't we?
Whoa.
The
Chair recommends to reoppose on every census.
Well, that is, that's right, next year.
It's coming up.
Any other discussion? Seeing none, all in favor, please say yes. Opposed, no. Clerk call the roll.
Dan Straylin.
Yes.
DeYoung.
Yes.
Brandhorst.
Yes.
Peterson.
Yes.
Motion carried. On to item number two, resolution number 6022, entitled a resolution approving the credit of community services fees and the placement of signs within the right-of-way in support of home-based Iowa program. Mike, could you explain?
Yes, Mr. Mayor. Once again, I'd like to thank you once again for the presentation of this item. As the mayor said this evening, this resolution will be approved in the incentive package and also allow for the placement of signage in the public right-of-way. Ultimately, this is supportive of the home-based Iowa program, which is an initiative launched by the governor and is intended to help military veterans transition and find jobs in Iowa. Specifically, when we talk about incentives for veterans, as part of this resolution, it would be a one-time $250 credit toward any program or service offered by our community services department. And we also have a one-time waiver of $250 on any building permits for new homes or remodels that would be a veteran would be eligible for as well. But let's go ahead, please, Corey. Now, if approved by this, signage would be placed everywhere that you see a star, a yellow star up here on the big board, and it would be placed with existing poles within our community as well. So with this, Mr. Mayor, once again, this resolution approves an incentive program to encourage home-based Iowa, which is a program intended to help military veterans transition to find jobs in the state of Iowa.
Thank you, Mike. Do I hear a motion for approval? Discussion? Is this the last step, Mike? Is there anything else that needs to move forward with, or is this the final?
Well, I think with this, we have a resolution which authorizes the community service fees, and we also got an ordinance on the agenda tonight that takes care of the building permit fees. That has to be done by an ordinance as well. So that technically is the last step.
All right. Very good.
Thank you, Mike.
Any other questions?
Could we just put something in the next city newsletter so that we get, because there may be some people who have moved in already and they're still within that 1 year of eligibility that may want to take advantage of this.
Yeah.
We do that?
Yeah. I'll follow up with the Pace Alliance because I know they're driving it.
Okay.
So I'll check with them and yeah.
Okay, good.
Good point. Thanks, Larry. Any other discussion? Seeing none, all in favor, please say yes. Opposed, no. Clerk call the roll.
DeYoung.
Yes.
Dan Straylin.
Yes.
Peterson.
Yes.
Brandhorst.
Yes.
Motion carried. On to item number three, resolution number 6023, entitled a resolution approving the street finance report for fiscal year ending June 30, 2019.
Yeah, Mayor, once again, this resolution to approve the street finance report for June 30, 2019. And it would also authorize staff to file a report with the Iowa Department of Transportation. Now, as far as a summary report on this, there is detail included in the council packet. The reason this is important is this report is necessary to receive road use tax funds for the city of Pella. That's the city's allotment of the state gas tax that we have here. And if you look at our share of that, that's roughly $1,337,000 that we received last year. Total revenues that we use in our street department total just over $1,620,000. As far as expenditures, I want to stress this was a planned drawdown, and usually when you talk about expenditures exceeding revenues, it's usually typically due to some construction projects that we had for last year. That would be fiscal year June 30, 2019. We had total expenditures of over $1,941,000 for the heavy street construction budget. $877,000 in tax fund. That's only a portion of the projects that we have with the streets funded with street construction support to note. But anyway, Mr. Mayor, approval of the resolution will authorize approval of the report and submission to the Iowa Department of Transportation. It is necessary to file this report to receive on an annual basis our road use tax funds, which total roughly $1.3 million.
Thank you, Mike. Do I hear a motion for approval?
Some support.
Yeah. Support Peterson. Discussion? Seeing none, all in favor, please say yes. Opposed, no. Clerk call the roll.
DeYoung.
Yes.
Peterson.
Yes.
Brandhorst.
Yes.
Dan Straylin.
Yes.
Motion carried. Item number four, resolution number 6024, entitled a resolution approving and authorizing a form of interim loan and disbursement agreement by and between the $50,000 sewer revenue capital loan notes and anticipation project note, series number 2019 of the City of Pella, Iowa, under the provisions of the Code of Iowa and providing for a method of payment of said note. Mike, could you explain, please?
We'll try to be concise with this one, Mr. Mayor, but in essence, just as background on the side of it, in 2018, the council did approve an agreement with Fox Engineering for proposed wastewater treatment plant improvements. Now, these improvements, proposed improvements were mandated by the Iowa Department of Natural Resources. It's very important to note. The loan agreement that we're considering this evening is intended to cover the engineering component of the project and the design phase of the project specifically. And what's being proposed is a $370,000 loan that would be valid for up to 3 years at a 0% interest. What happens at the end of 3 years is we would roll into the regular construction loan that would fund the construction cost of the project through the state revolving fund. Now, let's go ahead, please, Corey. It is important to note that when we talk about the entire project, it is a $4.8 million project. This was, once again, as part of the mandated improvements by the Iowa Department of Natural Resources. We want to make sure council clearly understands that this loan by itself will not increase rates for it. However, we believe that if you do not take advantage of this 0% loan, the rate increase will be higher to fund these mandated improvements that are being required by the state of Iowa. So once again, it's a $370,000 loan over 3 years, 0% interest rate. Overall, if you were to ask us right now, if we had to propose a rate increase to cover everything from what obviously the information that we know, we'd be recommending a 24% rate increase as council is where we approach this on a 1 year basis. And we tended to look at it on an annual basis and try to do the best to whittle things down. So that's what we see if we were to want some rate increase. We do not do that. What we'll do is on an annual basis with this. So once again, the loan by itself will not cause a higher rate increase in this, but if you don't take advantage of a 0% loan, rates will be higher. So with that, Mr. Mayor, that concludes our presentation. Do you want to have any answering questions the mayor or council may have on this item?
Thank you, Mike. Do I hear a motion for approval?
So moved.
Brandenhorst, support. Ms. Dryland, discussion? Can we borrow more than 310? Just kidding. Seeing no discussion, all in favor, please say yes, opposed, no. Clerk, call the roll.
Brandenhorst?
Yes.
Van Stryland?
Yes.
Peterson?
Yes.
DeYoung?
Yes.
Motion carried. On to item five, resolution number 6025, entitled resolution approving a first amendment to the agreement with KAL Services, Inc., DBA Midwest Sanitation. Mike, can you explain, please?
Yes, Mr. Mayor, I'd be happy to. As Mayor stated, this resolution will approve the first amendment with our current contract, Midwest Sanitation. Purpose of the contract and amendment is to provide solid waste management services for the City of Pella. Now, this amendment here, what's being proposed, is a 3 year contract extension. There's no additional changes to the contract, so the current rates and fees will stay the same under the contract term we have right here. But we have listed up here on the big board a brief description of the services performed by Midwest Sanitation. Now, overall, staff has been pleased with the service that Midwest Sanitation has provided to the City of Pella, and we also believe that it is being provided at a reasonable price. And we are recommending approval of the resolution this evening, which simply extends the contract through July 31st, 2023.
Thank you, Mike. Do I hear a motion for approval?
So moved.
Brandenhorst, support DeYoung. Discussion? Seeing none, all in favor, please say yes, opposed, no. Clerk, call the roll.
Brandenhorst?
Yes.
DeYoung?
Yes.
Van Stryland?
Yes.
Peterson?
Yes.
Motion carried. Item six, resolution number 6026, entitled resolution declaring an official intent under Treasury Regulation 1.150-2 to issue debt to reimburse the city for certain original expenditures paid in connection with specified projects. Mike, can you explain, please?
Yes, Mr. Mayor. Now, the background on this request that we are making this evening is important to note that the current fiscal year we have two projects that are budgeted for the City Hall. One is the reconstruction of University Street, and the other is proposed hard surfacing improvements on 218th Avenue at the City Soccer Complex. We have proposed engineering agreements on both of those projects later on, and the agenda tonight. And overall, when we total both of these, they total right around $863,000. Now, the budget called for a debt issuance to fund both of these projects. In order to issue debt, you have to file what's called a reimbursement resolution. And what this reimbursement resolution does is simply this resolution does not obligate the city to issue debt to fund the project. It simply keeps open our options to issue debt for the projects, and it's necessary to satisfy the treasury regulations of the United States government. So with that, Mr. Mayor, that concludes our presentation. This evening, we'll be more than happy to answer any questions on this side.
Thank you, Mike. Do I hear a motion for approval?
So moved.
Support Skyland. Support DeYoung. Discussion? Seeing none, all in favor, please say yes. Opposed, no. Clerk, call the roll.
Dan Stryland.
Yes.
DeYoung.
Yes.
Brandhorst.
Yes.
Peterson.
Yes.
Motion carried. Item 7, resolution number 6027, entitled Resolution Approving Engineering Services Agreement with Garden and Associates for the University Street Reconstruction. Mike, if you'd explain.
Yes, Mr. Mayor, I'd be happy to. And as the mayor said, this resolution to approve the proposed engineering services agreement with Garden and Associates for the proposed University Street Reconstruction Project. And this is the reconstruction project from University Street East 8 out to Farmer Street, or this yellow highlighted area right here. And when we look at the reconstruction project, it's also at this time the proposed realignment project as well. But we have the tentative proposed realignment of the University Street. I want to say it's tentative because as a part of this project, we also intend to solicit input from the Pella Community School District as well. In addition, we'll also hold additional work sessions with City Council on the alignment as well as we propose. But let's go ahead, please, court. Now, as far as the fees that's being considered this evening, what we have is the design fees, which is totaled over $36,000. A big component of this project, as most projects, is construction and observation, which totals $54,000. Altogether, the total engineering services agreement is approximately $95,500. Now, as far as the engineer's preliminary estimate for the project, it's right at $414,000. And as we said, as we proceed through the engineering component of the project, we will solicit input from the Pella Community School District, and then ultimately the realignment or the alignment of the University Street will ultimately be determined by the City Council on this project as well. But tonight, what is being proposed is an engineering services agreement approved by Council. We'll be on course to actually undertake this project in calendar year 2000. I believe that concludes our presentation this evening. Be more than happy to answer any questions the council may have on this item.
Thank you, Mike. Do I hear a motion for approval?
So moved.
Peterson?
Support.
Support. DeYoung? Discussion? Seeing none, all in favor, please say yes. Opposed, no. Clerk, call the roll.
Peterson?
Yes.
DeYoung?
Yes.
Brandhorst?
Yes.
Dan Stryland?
Yes.
Motion carried. Item number 8, resolution number 6028, entitled Resolution Approving Engineering Services Agreement with Garden and Associates for the 218th Avenue Paving Project. Mike, if you'd explain, please.
Yes, Mr. Mayor, I'd be happy to. As the mayor said, once again, we have another engineering services agreement proposal with Garden and Associates. This one's for the 218th paving project. We have a description up here on the big board when we talk about the paving and hard surfacing of this road, but just worrying pavement. And the drive is right over here. The section of the road is currently a gravel road that extends down to the Shady Grove subdivision. It's being proposed as this would be hard surface up here as well. Well, let's go ahead, please, court. Now, as far as the proposed fees this evening, we have a total proposed fees of $118,000. And you can see the various components we have here, but once again, construction and observation is a significant component of the job. We also anticipate, when you talk about the alignment, or if we can go back one slide as well, as far as the engineering fees are a little bit higher than what we usually anticipate. We also anticipate additional work sessions with the City Council when we get up to this curve. There's been a lot of discussion on this curve, whether this needs to be a key intersection or the geometry associated with this curve. There's additional work sessions with the engineers to solicit Council's input on the design of that as well. So let's go ahead, please, Corey. We talked about the engineering fees of $118,000. That's significant. That's a component, and please realize that as well. Council were to approve this agreement, we would be on course to actually have this job completed in the summer of 2020. So with that, Mr. Mayor, that concludes our presentation this evening. Be more than happy to answer any questions the mayor and council may have on this item.
Thank you, Mike. Do I hear a motion for approval?
So moved.
Ben Stryland?
Support.
Support Brandhorst. Discussion?
I have one question. It deals with Boss Land and Hawaii and Boss Land and Drive. They're in the capital improvement project for the next budget year, 2021?
I believe I'd have to rehash my memory, but I believe it might be fiscal year. It's somewhere right around that time period for those roads.
Now, if this is going to start in the summer of 2020, what type of an impact is that going to have on, if the 2021 budget is approved with that item in it, what type of impact is that going to have on those two projects?
I wouldn't think from a logistical standpoint it would have any, because what would happen if that project's approved for fiscal year 2021 would be most likely the summer of 21 construction season, which means that we would be doing engineering in the fall of 2020 for those projects.
Like doing now for...
Yeah, okay. So a very similar process to what we're doing with University Street, 218th Avenue. We would do the engineering in the fall, and it'd be the following summer for construction.
As we all know, that section of Boss Landing Roads is a very, very poor shape.
You're talking about the west end?
West end and east end, both sides, yeah. Both entrances are in poor shape. In fact, you did a nice job.
Yeah, that was the largest pour our crews ever made there on that front end, on the east end.
Well, they put in another pour just today.
We're doing a bunch of patches. Yeah. We're going to do some patches on the west end too, because it's hollow. Yeah. When we do redo that quarter mile, we'll be putting cutoff walls and sub drains because it's eroded. There's
major project.
There's a major void, like a small river underneath that street.
But I'm glad you fixed that other entrance on the east side, because that concrete was breaking up. Yeah. Thank you, Jenny. Okay, thanks.
Any other discussion? Seeing none, all in favor, please say yes. Opposed, no. Clerk, call the roll.
Van Strylen?
Yes.
Raderhorst?
Yes.
Peterson?
Yes.
DeYoung?
Yes.
Motion carried. Item number 9, resolution number 6029, entitled Resolution Approving the Professional Services Agreement with Civil Design Advantage, also known as CDA, for the Master Planning Services for the Old Power Plant Site. Mike, can you explain, please?
Yes, Mr. Mayor, now, background on this, or not background, but this resolution approved with Professional Services Agreement with Civil Design Advantage. And as the council is aware, Civil Design Advantage is actually the engineering and architectural firm that designed the Pella Sports Park on this as well. Now, as background on the project, in July of this year, we discussed a potential project with the Pella Historical Society for a proposed tulip field project, narrowed down to proposed sites, and looked at proposed site, the key site, the primary site being the old power plant site. Now, with this, we have a brief description of things that could be included as far as the ultimate project when we talk about beautification of Pella power plant site, and that's the purpose of the master planning agreement. This evening is to come up with a roadmap or a game plan or a proposed master plan, excuse me, for the proposed improvements on the site. Let's go ahead and take score. Now, just to orientate everyone, when we talk about the Pella power plant site, it's approximately 3 acre site that's located right here off Spruce Street. It's just to the North Pella Corporation, it's located right here. The agreement that we are considering this evening totals just over $16,000. Now, when we talked about this project at the time of the council back in July, we talked about a proposed agreement with the Pella Historical Society and looking to develop that. And looking at this agreement and when we would likely consider this agreement, also considering the timing of the project, I think there was a consensus, at least the direction staff received from the council back in, we talked about this in July, and also the strong preference of the Historical Society, is to have this potentially ready to construct in the summer of 2020. In order to meet that timeline, Councilmember Branderhorst and Councilmember Bacco, we sat on our ad hoc committee along with members of the Pella Historical Society and the Pella Corporation and interviewed the firms. The staff talked to both council members on this, and what's being proposed tonight is for the city to fund the agreement with CDA, master plan out of this. We utilize funds from the general fund over $16,000. And as cost estimates for the project are developed, and we have a known quantity on what that is, long in addition with the design, we thought we'd be in a much better position to actually negotiate an agreement with the Historical Society for cost allocations on this. And so to expedite this project, and also so we can consider this during our 2021 budget process, what we're proposing is for the city to undertake the master plan of the project, get the project going, and that would also allow us to complete it in time for the 2021 budget process, at which time we would be in a better position to negotiate an agreement with the sign the public sports park for proposed beautification project at the Pella College site. And with that, Mr. Mayor, we can move ahead and answer questions the mayor and council may have on this item.
Thank you, Mike. Do I hear a motion for approval?
So moved.
Support.
I'm sorry, Peterson, support DeYoung. Discussion? For the kickoff meeting, who participates in that kickoff meeting? Will that be the ad hoc committee as well as CDA?
Yeah, there's been a lot of, it'll be the engineer, we'll have staff members, Mr. Jeanette Vaughn will be a part of this, and we'll, of course, extend the two council members, Councilmember Brandhorst and Councilmember Bachhoven as well, but it's likely going to be our group plus members of the Pella Historical Society and Pella Corporation as well.
Okay. All right. Very good. Thank you. Any other questions?
I just have a comment. One of the reasons we need to have start to expedite the process as well is we have 5,000 test tulips that need to get in the ground. And so we felt that time was of the essence to get those in.
This fall yet?
Yes. Wow. My understanding.
That's correct.
Yep. So if you'd like to volunteer to help Nick plant them, Mark, just. Yeah, like.
Where does that fit on the honeydew?
Yeah.
I won't ask because
pretty
I have
high.
My own, I have my
pretty
own
high,
list.
Yes.
All right. Any other discussion? Seeing none, all in favor, please say yes. Opposed, no. Clerk, call the roll.
Peterson?
Yes.
DeYoung?
Yes.
Brandhorst?
Yes.
Van Strylen?
Yes.
Motion carried. Thank you for organizing the planting of those tulips. And everything else.
Pardon me?
Did you ever get a soil test back on that?
I think Jeanette, is she here? I think that they've done a soil test. Is that correct, or are doing a soil test?
No, for where the 5,000 tulips are.
Right.
I'm sorry. No, we just went and picked a spot we thought looked good.
Okay.
Looks a little iffy, doesn't it?
All right, very good. Item number 10, resolution number 6030, entitled resolution making award and approving construction contract and bond for the Tunnel Cabin Learning Walkway Project. Mike, if you'd explain, please.
I think this was the mayor stated with this resolution to do an improvement construction contract for the proposed Tunnel Learning Month project. Now, as a background on this, in November of 2018, the City Council approved a partnership with the Historical Trust to create a learning walk that would connect Tunnel Cabin with Central Gardens Park. And the map that we have up here, I believe we have Tunnel Cabin is located right here. Central Gardens is right here. And the proposed project of learning walk is located right here in Vacated Alley. Now, as far as the terms of the agreement, it's under the terms, this walk will eventually be owned, will actually be constructed and owned and maintained by the City of Pella. However, the Historic Pella Trust would pay for 100% of the cost of the project, which includes engineering and construction. Let's go ahead and please report. Now, as far as the agreement itself that we have, the bids for the project, one bid was received for the project, which was Concrete Connection of Johnston, Iowa. And you can see the various components of the various bids that they had right here. And as well as the alternative, which was to add brick pavers. With this, it is important to note that the construction contract is just the hard surface pathway that leads on the walkway. And for an additional $22,500 was for an alternate add brick pavers to the hard surface. It is important to note for the hard surface component of the project, the engineer's estimate cost was just over $96,000. The engineer on the project is Klinger and Associates, and they are recommending awarding the contract to Concrete Connection for spring completion in the amount of $85,000. The Historic Pella Trust is also requesting that the annual contract alternative for pavers, the contract for full contract amount of $107,500. And with that, Mr. Mayor, please, I complete the presentation.
Thank you, Mike. Do I hear a motion for approval?
So moved.
Support. Van Strylen. Support DeYoung. Discussion? To be clear, the $107,500 is paid by the Historic Pella Trust and not the city, correct?
That is correct.
Any other comments? Seeing none, all in favor, please say yes. Opposed, no. Clerk, call the roll.
Van Strylen.
Yes.
DeYoung.
Yes.
Brandhorst.
Yes.
Peterson.
Yes.
Motion carried. On to number 11, resolution number 6031, entitled the resolution approving the ordering of the preparation of plans, specifications, formal contract, notice of hearing, and notice of letting, setting the date for public hearing, authorizing the taking of bids, and authorizing bid opening for the wastewater treatment plant 2019 upgrades. Mike, can you explain, please?
Yeah, said earlier this evening, these proposed upgrades are being mandated by the Iowa Department of Natural Resources. Now, as a part of this, you'll see several long-term proposed improvements as a part of this project. It's really intended to prevent me the next 20 years of service for the community, as well as address the various enhanced treatment options that we need to undertake that are being mandated by the Iowa Department of Natural Resources. Now, the engineer on the project is Fox Engineering, and council would approve this resolution and authorize city staff take all and every necessary action to solicit bids for the project. Critical dates that we have up on here on the big board would be a bid letting would be held on November 12th, a public hearing, and contract consideration would be held on November 19th by the city council. We'd be hoping to issue a notice to proceed on the project if approved by council on the 19th on December 3rd. And if everything goes as planned, the project would be done before the end of 2021. Overall, the engineer's opinion and probable cost for the project is just under $4.9 million. And staff is recommending approval of the resolution. Mr. Mayor, once again, the only thing that really obligates the city to do is conduct a public hearing on November 19th for the project.
Thank you, Mike. Do I hear a motion for approval?
So.
Peterson. Support DeYoung. Discussion? Seeing none, all in favor, please say yes. Opposed, no. Clerk, call the roll.
Peterson?
Yes.
DeYoung?
Yes.
Randerhorst?
Yes.
Van Strylen?
Yes.
Motion carried. That was a lot of resolutions. I'm ready to move on to ordinances.
That's a lot of record, wasn't it?
I think it really was. Item number one under ordinance is number 965, entitled an ordinance amending the city code of the city of Pella, Iowa by amending chapter 171, schedule of rates and fees pertaining to the building permit fees for the purpose of allowing waivers in support of the home-based Iowa community program. This is the first reading. Mike, can you explain, please?
Yeah, thank you, Mr. Mayor. Once again, what this ordinance simply does is it allows us to offer a one-time waiver for the whole Iowa home-based project that is intended to encourage veterans to locate and find jobs within the state of Iowa. It authorizes veterans to receive a one-time waiver of $250 on any building permit for a new home or remodels. And since council approved this program earlier this evening, we are recommending approval of the ordinance this evening, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you, Mike. Do I hear a motion for approval?
So moved.
DeYoung? Support Van Strylen. Discussion? I just wanted to go on record and say that this is a program that I feel very strongly about. I think it's an awesome program, and I'm very pleased to be able to add Pella to the list of supporting communities. And I'd also like to point out that if we had two additional council members, we would just probably move right on forward and adopt this ordinance. But since we're not at full staff, we're unable to do that. But I would anticipate that moving forward very expeditiously at our next meeting. So, that being said, any other discussion? Seeing none, all in favor, please say yes. Opposed, no. Clerk, call the roll.
DeYoung?
Yes.
Van Strylen?
Yes.
Peterson?
Yes.
Randerhorst?
Yes.
Motion carried. On to claims. Abstract of bills number 2040. Do I hear a motion for approval?
Move to approve and issue warrants.
Motion to approve and issue warrants by DeYoung.
Support.
Support Peterson. Discussion? Seeing none, all in favor, please say yes. Opposed, no. Clerk, call the roll.
DeYoung?
Yes.
Peterson?
Yes.
Randerhorst?
Yes.
Van Strylen?
Yes.
Motion carried. We will now move on to other business, public forum. If there's anyone in attendance that would like to bring any business before the council, please step forward, give us your name, your address, and keep your comments to 3 minutes if possible, please. Do any council members have anything that they would like to bring forward at this time? Seeing none, let's go to policy and planning, and we will take on the proposed development agreement with Laley North America at this time. Do I have a motion to enter in closed session pursuant to Iowa Code Chapter 21.51J to discuss the purchase or sale of a particular real estate only where the premature disclosure could be reasonably expected to increase the price the governmental body would have to pay for that property or reduce the price the governmental body would receive for that property?
So.
Randerhorst?
Support.
Peterson? All in favor, please say yes. Opposed, no. Clerk, call the roll.
Randerhorst?
Yes.
Peterson?
Yes.
DeYoung?
Yes.
Van Strylen?
Yes.
We will adjourn to closed session. All right, very good. We are back in open session. Do I hear a motion regarding any issues that were discussed during closed session? Seeing none, do I hear a motion to adjourn?
So moved.
Peterson, support DeYoung. All in favor, please say yes, opposed no. Clerk call the roll.
Peterson?
Yes.
DeYoung?
Yes.
Reinderhorst?
Yes.
Van Strylen?
Yes.
We are adjourned.